are out here to look at the BOSH project. That stands for Bruneau, Owyhee, Sage-Grouse Habitat Project. It's a large juniper project in the Bruneau and the Owyhee field offices in southwest Idaho. The project area is a 1.7 million acre project area, and within that area we're looking at 617,000 acres of early stage juniper removal. The purpose of the project is to protect this kind of ecosystem behind me. This is the sagebrush-steppe landscape. It's an incredibly important landscape. It's home to 350 species of plants and animals. It's also home to multiple use lands that the Bureau of Land Management administers. These are lands that are used for livestock grazing and for recreation.
Juniper, western juniper, are native species, but historically they've been found in more of the rocky outcroppings in this area. Over time, and with aggressive fire suppression, juniper have encroached out into these areas, and they outcompete other native plant species, sagebrush, your perennial bunch grasses, your forbs.
That is what juniper naturally will do unchecked, is become a closed juniper stand. So we're trying to preserve the diversity we have in situations like this, where we have shrubs, we have forbs, we have grasses, we still have juniper, but it's not just a monoculture of one thing out there.
Well, really what we're doing here is turning the sagebrush steppe habitat, that's a marginal nesting habitat for grouse, into immediate quality nesting habitat for grouse. And given at the landscape scale that it is, we're trying to provide connectivity between these different grouse populations within the BOSH landscape.
As you look up the mountain behind me, you'll see some really dense areas there to the west. That's not what we're treating. As you come down the mountain, you're looking for that scattered juniper, like directly behind me. That's classic phase one juniper encroachment, early phase two encroachment into the sagebrush steppe. So we're targeting those scattered trees or younger trees in that landscape to treat. So we're using a couple things when we delineate where to treat. We're looking at proximity to sagebrush leks. So right where we're at, there's three active leks behind us and a couple to the east. So proximity to leks, and then less than 20% juniper cover and greater than 15% sagebrush cover. So the idea is, once we cut those juniper, we're going to have actual sage grouse habitat right after we cut that juniper. This summer, early fall, it's going to look a lot like potentially bitterbrush or sagebrush, dark sagebrush out there on the landscape. But come next spring, it's really going to be noticeable. All those trees are going to turn red. In about 2 years, that red will fall off the needles. And unless you know what you're looking for, you're going to have a hard time depicting whether there were trees there to begin with or not.
Once we've taken the juniper out, we get all of the regrowth of the native species and grasses coming back in. And just on my own ranch, where I've done some work with NRCS, we've been able to increase numbers of livestock on my own private properties, which is quite amazing, and still have a lot of grass left over for the wildlife.
This really is a partnership between everyone that works in this landscape, all the way down to working with the landowners on the private side. And without that ability to communicate back and forth freely and having these good relationships, we really wouldn't be doing these level of projects that we are today.